بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، أشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا. Welcome my brothers in Islam to lesson 188 في العربية بين يديك، book 1 part 1 of the new version. وقفنا أيها الإخوة عند صفحة 126. We stopped at page 126 of book 1 part 1 of the new version. التدريب الثالث، the third exercise. تبادل الحوار مع زميلك كما في المثالين. Exchange the conversation with your classmate like in the two examples. So the two examples literally means المثالان with ألف نون, but dual form gets a ya nun instead of ألف نون when confronted by حرف جر, a preposition. المثال الأول, the first example, هل تشرب الشاي؟ Do you drink tea? And putting ال التعريف is not compulsory, so you can say هل تشرب شايا؟ Do you drink tea? الجواب أو جواب الطالب الثاني, the answer of the second student is لا أفضل القهوة. By not, so the meaning here is no, I prefer coffee. And by not putting, my brothers in Islam, the comma, you get a totally different answer, a totally opposite answer. So saying لا أفضل القهوة means I don't prefer coffee. So you're negating. So the فاصلتون is very important. The comma is very important, my brothers in Islam. المثال الثاني, هل تأكل اللحم؟ Do you eat meat? الجواب لا. أفضل السمك. No. I prefer fish. طيب. ابدأ الآن. Start now. الأجوبة إخوتي في الله, the answers, my brothers in Islam. First of all, we have a problem here. هناك مشكلة في الصورة الأولى. There is a problem in the first picture. صورة الأرز والخبز معكوستان. So the picture of the rice and the bread, as you can see, they are معكوستان. Or you can say مقلوبتان. Okay. So they are reversed. They are turned. Yeah? They are the other way round. So that's what this word means. مقلوبتان. Yeah? They're turned. Yeah? معكوستان. They're turned. So the word معكوس is the single form. And معكوستان is the dual form. مقلوب is the other way around. So as you can see, the picture of the rice should come before the picture of the bread, just like the other ones where you see that they are in order. So you just have to imagine the rice picture should be on the right side and the bread picture on the left side. And this can happen, يعني a mistake can happen, as you know. إذن وهكذا في صحيح وهكذا في صورة العنب. And likewise, وهكذا, there is ألف between the ها and the كاف, pronounced not written. هكذا means likewise. في صورة العنب والتمر. Likewise in the picture of the dates, the grapes and the dates. They are the other way around. So you should imagine that the عنب surah, the picture of the grapes is on the right side and the dates picture on the left side. We find the same issue with the ماء and قهوة as well. Okay. على كل حال, what means anyway, سنبدأ إن شاء الله, we will start إن شاء الله. طيب. هل تأكل الأرز؟ لا أفضل الخبز. And if you want you can use you can do it without the ألف التعريف. هل تأكل أرزا with the ألف after the زاي؟ لا أفضل خبزا. No, I prefer bread with an ألف ممدودة after the زاي. طيب. هل تشرب الحليب؟ لا أفضل الماء. Do you drink milk? No, I prefer water. هل تأكل العنب؟ Do you eat grapes? لا أفضل التمر. لا أفضل التمر. No, I prefer dates. هل تشرب الماء؟ Do you drink water? لا أفضل القهوة. No, I prefer coffee. التدريب الرابع, the fourth exercise, تبادل السؤال والجواب مع زملائك. Exchange the question and the answer with your classmates. So زملاء with همزة on the سطر ممنوع من الصرف is classmates slash colleagues. وفي هذا السياق in this context تعني it means classmates because we are not on the work floor. طيب. الطالب الأول, the first student, آكل اللحمة. I eat meat. اللحمة مفعول به. It's an object. Okay. Where is the subject? It's أنا. ضمير مستتر. It's hidden pronoun. تقديره أنا. It's estimated as I. Anyway, آكل اللحمة. I eat meat. ماذا تأكل? What do you eat? آكل الدجاجة. I eat chicken. ماذا تأكل? What do you eat? لدي سؤالان أيها الإخوة. I have two questions. السؤال الأول, if a woman was to address another woman, okay, كيف سيكون السؤال? How will the question be? What is the feminine form of I eat meat? And this is a tricky one because nothing actually changes. So a woman likewise says آكل اللحمة. Never change the I form. There is only one I form. That's both for masculine and feminine, whether it's past or present. Okay? So the difference comes in the you form. So ماذا تأكل is what do you eat, masculine, or what does she eat? What is the feminine for what do you eat? ماذا تأكلين with a ya and a noon. And never put the alif on the noon. Okay? Just a noon with a fatha. ماذا تأكلين? What do you feminine eat? ماذا تأكلين يا فاطمة? What do you eat, O فاطمة? السؤال الثاني, كيف نحول هذا الفعل المضارع إلى الماضي? How do we change this present tense verb to the past tense? So I ate meat. What did you eat in the past? أكلت اللحمة with the open ta and a dhamma. This I ate, both for masculine and feminine, because I told you the I form in the past and present is both for male and female. أكلت اللحم. I ate meat. ماذا أكلت? What did you eat? Or if you speak to a woman, ماذا أكلت? With also an open ta but with a كسرة. ابدأ الآن. Start now. إذن اللحم اسم مفعول به is an object because the verb plus the what question. I ate what? I eat what? اللحمة. And if you say أكلت لحما indefinite, it's totally fine. It's not a must to put أل التعريف. And sometimes putting أل التعريف might confuse English speaking people because they will translate it as I eat the meat. And the Arabs, they actually mean with it I eat meat and not the meat. But like I told you, أل doesn't mean always the. ابدأ الآن. Start now. I was just thinking, if you was my son, if you was my son, you were just sitting there and waiting for me to reply. I would have punished you. طيب. الأجوبة to the answers. آكل الأرز. ماذا تأكل؟ آكل الخبز. ماذا تأكل؟ آكل الدجاج. ماذا تأكل؟ آكل السمك. ماذا تأكل؟ آكل السلطة. ماذا تأكل؟ آكل الفاكهة. ماذا تأكل؟ آكل العنب. ماذا تأكل؟ آكل التمر. ماذا تأكل? Definitely one of the most difficult topics that we have gone through, I mean me and you brothers in Islam, is the topic of اسم جنس جمعي. This is the most difficult topic I think that we have done up to now because it's kind of confusing to many brothers in Islam. I just want to very briefly say that the اسم جنس جمعي, from one angle, it's a plural form. It's a plural verb. Okay, it's a plural noun that gets singular by just adding the term marbuta. But on the other hand, you can say it's not a plural form. It really depends on the context. Okay. So if I say for example, لدي عنب, I have grapes. It's plural here. Okay, because عنبتون is one grape. Okay, لدي سمكون, I have fish, plural, because if you just have one fish, it's سمكتون. لدي تمر في البيت, I have dates at home, meaning plural, because تمرتون is one. خبزون likewise, اشتريت خبزا, I bought bread. Like I said, it's خبزتون is just one. But on the other hand, okay, the اسم جنس جمعي might just be a single form noun. Because if you say آكل الخبزة, I eat bread, it's the gender bread. آكل الدجاجة, I eat chicken. Okay, or if you say أكلت دجاجا, I ate chicken. أكلت خبزا, I ate bread. It's a general form, general noun, meaning you might have eaten just a quarter of a chicken or one loaf of bread. Okay, so the اسم جنس جمعي is very it's a tricky one. I don't know if I can say tricky, maybe that's not the right word. If I say أنا آكل السمك, I eat fish, it's general. Okay, you don't say how much fish do you eat. I only can give you 100% a plural form if I say أكلت أسماكا. I have eaten أسماك. أسماك can only be three or more. Okay? Just like you say برتقالات, oranges. But if you say برتقال, it can be a plural and it can also be not plural. So this is definitely one of the most difficult topics, and you can inshallah go more deeper into it inshallah. Okay? In the class, you just get the keys, but at home, you can go deeper into detail. طيب التدريب الخامس في صفحة 127, the fifth exercise at page 127. تبادل الحوار مع زميلك كما في المثال. Exchange the conversation with your classmate as or like in the example. المثال, the example, أين الغداء؟ الغداء على المائدة. أنا جوعان جدا. لدينا ضيوف. من؟ والدي ووالدتي وجدي. الترجمة, the translation, you always translate before I do to get most out of it, even if you make a mistake. You will get more out of it than just stay silent and don't translate in your mind. إذن, أين الغداء؟ Where is the lunch? Here, L really means the. You mean specific lunch. Where is the lunch that we just spoke about? Specific. It's definite. It's not indefinite. Here, L means really the. Okay? If you say, أين غداء؟ Where is a lunch? Any lunch. Give me any lunch. But here, L means the. Where is the lunch? And that's why also, as you can see, the effect of L is removing the تنوين. تنوين الرفعي. Removing one of the two dhammas. What we can benefit here as well is that أين has no effect upon the noun after it. So you don't say أين الغداء and you don't say أين الغداء. So أين is اسم استفهام, it's a questioning noun and it has no effect upon the noun after it. الغداء على المائدة, the food is on the table. يمكنك أن تقول, you can say what? What is another word for table? الغداء على الطاولة. Okay. على means on. And على is a حرف جر. So what we learn here is that after على we need a كسرة. Okay. Any, يعني using على in any sentence. For example, الكتاب على المكتب. The book is on the desk. Okay. There is another word and that is فوق. فا واو قاف. فوق means above. Okay? So you know the difference between on and above. Likewise, فوق is مضاف and not a حرف جر. Although the effect of حرف جر and مضاف are the same because the مضاف إليه has a كسرة and the اسم مجرور, the noun after the حرف جر has also a كسرة. ما جمع مائدة؟ What's the plural of مائدة؟ موائد, tables. بالهمزة على الكرسي, with the همزة on the chair. أنا جوعان جدا. I'm very hungry. جوعان ممنوع من الصرف. Has only one dhamma. And جدا has always two فتحة and an ألف. The only dispute that I told you, I going to write the two fatha on the alif or I going to write the two fatha on the dal, and I've told you this before. لدينا ضيوفٌ, we have guests with the English S. ضيفٌ, one guest. ضيفاني, two guests. الجمع ضيوفٌ. مفرد, مثنى, جمع. Single, dual, plural. من, who? For people you use men. Okay, for objects and animals you use ما, what? من, who? والدي, my father. ووالدتي, and my mother. وجدي, and my grandfather. Okay, So as you can see, my brothers in Islam, although duyufun is a plural for masculine, because we have daifatun, one feminine guest, daifatani, two, daifatun, three or more. So if we have a mix of men and women, then we always use the masculine plural and not the feminine plural, what is daifatun. Ladayna, we have. Ladayya, I have. Ladayka, you have. Ladayki, you feminine, have. If I will be on street and I would like speak with somebody on the street, I would use, or then in that situation you will read it or you will say it to the person you meet outside in this way. You say, أين الغداء؟ الغداء على المائدة. The top becomes a how when you stop. أنا جوعان جدا. And if you say jiddan, that is also very common. But that's the situation and Allah knows best. Ladayna duyuf. You don't say duyufun at the end of the sentence when you're outside. You use the Quranic style and that's to give it a sukun sound. Okay. بل هو قرآن مجيد. As you can see in the Quran, Surah Al-Buruj. But you say قرآن مجيد, you give it سكون sound and not the two dhamma sound. من والدي ووالدتي وجدي. طيب. Let's see the notes إن شاء الله. الجملة تحتاج إلى همزة استفهام. أي جملة تحتاج إلى همزة استفهام؟ Which sentence does need a question mark? الجملة الأولى. نسيت همزة الاستفهام. يعني the question mark is forgotten and there's no problem. We don't blame anybody. We are not يعني reading this book to search for mistakes, because if I do that, then I think my heart is poisoned with hatred for my Muslim brothers. يعني if I'm reading this book just to search for a mistake and then you know, expose it to the people just like that because I love them to make mistakes, then there is something wrong with me. Okay. Yes, the scholars of the past, they have written refutations to some books where there is openly a call for innovation or even shirk and calling upon others than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of course, it's from the nasiha to write a refutation, but with the intention of nasiha for the ummah. You're advising the ummah not to fall in those innovations. And what you mostly see, that the scholars, they write a nasiha to the person to retract and to take back those innovations and to to bring out a new version of that book with taking those mistakes out, that shirk and kufr and disbelief. So if the writer still opposes and he spreads this evil and he prints his books in thousands and hundred thousands of prints, then yes, we need to refute that book and to show the ummah that this is it's a deviating book. طيب. Going back, my brothers in Islam, إذن نحتاج إلى همزة استفهام. We need a question mark here. أين الغداء؟ الغداء على المائدة. الغداء على المائدة. أنا جوعان جدا. I'm very hungry. لدينا ضيوف. Just can imagine, husband, he comes home very hungry, he works, He works to provide for the family with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He comes home and he starts saying, where is the lunch? Okay. You can say it in a polite way and you can say it in a more aggressive way. And the first is, of course, better. Where's the lunch? So the wife goes, the lunch is on the table. And he starts saying, I'm very hungry. And now this wife, this wise wife, Allahumma barik, she stops him by saying, Ladaina duyufun, don't touch the food, we have guests. Okay? Ladaina duyufun. وَهَذَا مِنَ الْآدَابِ الْإِسْلَامِيَةِ And this is from the Islamic etiquettes. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه on the authority of أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه أن رجلا أتى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن means that and the noun after أن gets a fatha أن رجلا like وأشهد أن محمدا as you can see two fatha صلى الله عليه وسلم so أن رجلا that a man أتى means came he came أتى خالد خالد came أتيت I came that a man came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم أتى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فبعث إلى نسائه so فبعث إلى نسائه فقلنا ما معنا إلا الماء so the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم he sent to his wives نساء is plural إلى سحرف جر إلى نسائه بعث means he sent so بعث خالد رسالة خالد sent a message بعث يبعث it's like أرسل يرسل همزة القطع is to send so the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم he sent to his wives فقلنا so they said قلنا ف means so فقلنا يعني they said feminine okay meaning to honor this guest, the man that came to the Prophet ﷺ. Look to the situation of the wives, look to the situation of the Prophet ﷺ and to the wives that they were not complaining about the situation. They just said, مَا مَعَنَا إِلَّا الْمَاءُ We have nothing except for water. Allahu Akbar. Prophet. Wives of the Prophet. It's only water in house. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم So the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said رسول is messenger نبي is prophet من يضم أو يضيف هذا I forgot also the question mark because it's a question like I said making a mistake is very normal the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said who is hosting this, يعني this person, من يضم أو يضيف هذا, and like I've mentioned before, to host a guest, you have multiple verbs for it. We have done the word استضاف يستضيف, همزة الوصل. You have also ضيف يضيف, it's also to host, and also we have أضاف يضيف. This here we find the verb يضيف. Who is hosting this, يعني this man, فقال رجل من الأنصار so a man from the Ansar said one man of the Ansar is Ansariyun هو Ansariyun يعني he's from the Ansar the inhabitants of the prophetic city المدينة النبوية the Muslims of المدينة النبوية of the time in the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم because in المدينة were also Jews so not everybody who lived in Medina is Ansari he has to be Muslim So Ansariyun jam'uhu Ansarun. So a man from the Ansar, he wanted the reward, he said, Ana, I, or me, because Ana means I or me, I will host him. فَانْطَلَقَ بِهِ So he went with him, إِلَى امْرَأَتِهِ To his wife. As you know, إِلَى زَوْجَتِهِ To his wife, إِلَى امْرَأَتِهِ To his wife. Although, in English, it means to his woman, يعني his wife. فقال so he said look what he said to his wife أكرمي ضيف رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Honor the guest of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. أكرم is the command verb for a man. And أكرمي is the command verb to a woman. أكرمي. أكرموا you lot. أكرما you too. It's a command verb. Look what he said. أكرمي. Honor. Show hospitality to the guest of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. فقالت, so she said, ما عندنا إلا قوت صبياني. ما عندنا, we have nothing except for the قوت of our children. Except for the food of our children. صبيان children. Okay. فقال, so he said, he quickly made up an idea with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No food except for some food of the children. It's the only thing they have in the house. What is he going to do? He said, هيئي طعامك, prepare your food. هيئ يهيئ, هيئ, prepare. هيئي طعامك, prepare your food. طعام مفعول به مضاف. وأصبحي سراجك. Okay. And turn on your light. Your lamp. ونومي صبيانك. And make your children sleep. ونومي صبيانك إذا أرادوا عشاء. If they want food, okay, if they want dinner, عفوا, make them sleep. فهيئت طعامها. So she prepared her food. وأصبحت سراجها. And she turned on the lamp, like oil lamp. ونومت صبيانها, and she made her children sleep. ثم قامت كأنها تصلح سراجها. Then she stood up like she is fixing her lamp, between two brackets, oil lamp, like she's fixing it, repairing it. فأطفأته. So she deliberately turned it off, the lamp. فجعل يريانه أنهما يأكلان. And they were showing the guest as they were eating. They were not eating.